Ayan, so hello at isa na namang napakagandang hapon ulit sa inyong lahat at isang maligayang pagbabalik dito sa ating E2Life Physical Science Live Session. Kumusta naman kayong lahat? No? Sana kayo ay nasa maayos na kalagayan. Ako nga pala ang inyong tutor ngayong araw, si Tutor Nel from SDO Pasig City. Ngayong araw, ang ika-anim na linggo sa fourth quarter ng Physical Science. Handa na ba kayong matuto? Pero, bago ang lahat, i-like at i-share ninyo sa inyong mga newsfeed ang ating live session para naman mas lalo pang dumami ang ating physical science family. At syempre, sa mga walang sawang sumusuporta sa ating mga live session, maraming maraming salamat po. Bago tayo magpatuloy sa ating kaabang-abang na topic ngayong hapon, ay atin munang bigyan ng kaunting oras para kilalanin ang ating mga partner schools na ating nakasama last week. For week number 5, maraming salamat po sa ating mga partner schools. Sa inyong suporta na ipinapakita sa ating E2Life Physical Science Live Session. At syempre, congratulations sa inyong pagiging hashtag mahusay. The partner schools for our last week's sessions are the following. San Mariano National High School, Maine from San Mariano, Isabela. Luis F. Gemantina National High School from Isabela. Godofredo Reyes Senior National High School from Camarines Sur. Pasay City East High School from Pasay City. Padre Garcia National High School from Batangas. Lorenzo S. Sarmiento Senior National High School from Davao de Oro. Aurora Senior High School from Isabela. Jones Rural School also from Isabela. And we have Pasay City North High School from Pasay City. And of course, Buting Senior High School from Pasig City. Diyan po ako nagtuturo. Okay? So congratulations po again sa ating mga partner schools. At syempre, kailangan din po nating awardan ang ating mga students of the week. Ito naman yung mga students or mga outstanding students na nakapagbigay ng mga outputs natin for the given activity last week. So again, congratulations sa inyong pagiging hashtag mahusay. Para sa ating mga students of the week, from Buting Senior High School, Pasig City, under the supervision of Mrs. Regina Molano Cruz, we have Vanessa A. Ginto from 11A BMA, Jamaica A. Atienza from 11A BMB, and Catherine O. Malate from 11A BMB. From 11A BMC, we have Champin Bagak, Kyla B. Realubit, Shannon Marie C. Mendez, Princess Anne C. Dange, Nicole M. Pareno, and Maria Angelina D. Cruz. From 11A BMD, from the same school, we have Carl R. Rimpula. And from ABME, again from Buting Senior High School, we have Mark Jason S. Ferrer, Jonah N. Donaire, and Maria May Angela M. Bautista. Okay, so ayan, congratulations again sa ating mga students of the week. Para sa ating mga live viewers, kung gusto ninyong makasama sa listahan ng ating mga students of the week, huwag kalimutan magpasa ng mga outputs para sa ating mga activity mamaya. Okay? So, let's proceed to our discussion. Narito ang ating most essential learning competencies or MELC na covered natin for this week. Number one, describe how Hertz produce radio pulses. And number two, explain how special relativity resolved the conflict between Newtonian mechanics and Maxwell's electromagnetic theory. Pero bago natin i-discuss ang ating mga topics, for today, mag-review muna tayo ng ating mga past discussion. Last session, the following things were discussed. Number one, a spoon acts both as a convex and a concave mirror, producing virtual and real images respectively. Next, mirage is an illusion created with refraction of light in layers of cold and hot air. Next, color filters allows light of its own color to pass through, otherwise light is just absorbed. And primary rainbows follow the reflect-reflect-refract route, while secondary rainbows do the refract-reflect-reflect-refract course. A cloud's color is determined by how much light scattering has taken place within it. And the color of the sky is determined by wavelength of white light that reaches the earth, or blue, that is during the day, and red or orange during sunrise and sunsets. So ayan, so napakadami natin na-discuss last week. Ano? Sana ay lahat ng ito ay inyong natutunan at naaalala pa hanggang sa ngayon para lagi po natin na-apply ang ating mga concept sa ating mga live session. Okay? Now, let us get started with the topic. Ang unang topic natin for today ay about radio waves. Okay? Before we deal with radio waves at kung paano ba ito na-produce, let us first talk about the theory of electromagnetism and the definition of electromagnetism itself. So according to this slide, electromagnetism is a subdivision of physics that is concerned with the study of interacting relationship of electric currents or fields and magnetic fields. Diba? Kaya ang tinawag na electromagnetism, it came from two words, no, electricity and at the same time, magnetism. So James Clerk Maxwell is a Scottish physicist who proposed the theory about the relationship of electric current and magnetic fields in 1873. This theory is actually called the theory of electromagnetism. So in this theory, he projected that the electric field, magnetic field, and light are different appearances of the same phenomena. So naniniwala siya, no, si Maxwell na yung electric field, magnetic field, and even light are related to one another. And in fact, they are just a projection, different projection of the same phenomenon. Now, this phenomenon is summarized in what we call the electromagnetic spectrum. So it is the entire range of wavelengths or frequencies of electromagnetic radiation extending from gamma rays to the longest radio waves and including the visible light. So itong picture na ito, lagi nyo nakikita sa ating mga physics books, di ba? Yung electromagnetic spectrum. And one part of this electromagnetic spectrum will be our focus for today's discussion. And that will be radio waves. So radio waves or radio pulses are also considered to be one of the most important discoveries the human has ever had because it made communication more efficient. Okay? So radio waves are very significant. They are extensively utilized in modern technology for cell phones, ICT, communications, broadcasting, navigation schemes, communication satellites, wireless fidelity or Wi-Fi routers, and numerous other applications. They also transport signals for televisions and mobile phones. If not absorbed, radio waves will bounce off items. So, doon sa ating electromagnetic spectrum, dito siya sa pinakadulong side makikita, no, itong radio waves. Ayan. So, Henrik Hertz, aside from Maxwell, meron another scientist, Heinrich Hertz, a German physicist, verified the existence of radio waves or pulses in late 1880s. So paano naman ito nagawa ni Hertz? Na paano niya kaya na patunayan na mayroong radio waves? Ano experiment kaya ang kanyang ginawa para ma-prove ang existence ng mga ito? So, Heinrich Hertz used a device called the spark gap transmitter to observe the production of radio waves. So itong drawing na ito, yung illustration na makikita nyo dito, this is actually a rough sketch of what Henry Hertz's device looks like. Okay? So yan. This is actually, itong image naman na ito, this is a replica of what Heinrich Hertz used to observe the production of radio pulses or radio waves. So Hertz proves the existence of radio waves in the late 1880s. He used two rods to serve as the receiver and a spark gap as the receiving antennae. Where the waves were picked up, a spark will jump, and Hertz showed in his experiments that these signals possess all of the properties of electromagnetic waves. So yung mga sparks na yon na na-pick up niya, those are actually the radio pulses. Noon kaya niya na-prove na existent talaga itong mga radio waves. Okay? So ito yung gap, makikita niyo dito yung parts ng ating spark gap device. So meron tayong first part, yung induction coil that produces high voltage. So this is your source. And then meron ka ditong spark gap. So dito nagkakaroon ng production ng spark that will connect this gap actually. No, kaya siya tawag yung spark gap experiment. Okay? Ayan. So, various frequencies of radio waves are used for televisions and FM and AM radio broadcasts, military communications, mobile phones, radar, wireless computer networks, and numerous other communications applications. Most radio waves pass freely through Earth's atmosphere. So ito yung mga reasons kung bakit important, no, yung radio waves, especially today where digital communication is prevalent, no? So sa tingin ninyo, ano kaya ang mangyayari sa atin kung hindi natin na-improve ang ating knowledge with regards to radio waves? Do you think we can have the things that we currently enjoy right now? No, so can you imagine a life without these kinds of communication? Like for example, satellites or yung mga GPS. Because all of this works with the premise of radio waves or radio pulses. So thanks to them, yung mga scientists natin na gumawa at nag-invest ng time and effort nila to develop these kinds of device. Okay? Now, let's move on to the next part of our discussion. This time, we are going to talk about the special theory of relativity. Before the special theory of relativity, mayroon muna tayong dalawang ideas na umiikot sa scientific community during those times. Ito ay ang Newtonian mechanics ni Isaac Newton. Alam kong kilala nyo naman si Isaac Newton. At ang theory of electromagnetism by James Clerk Maxwell. So, yung theory of electromagnetism, napagdaanan natin to kanina. Okay, i-discuss po natin itong dalawang theories na ito. Let's talk first about the Newtonian mechanics. So the following are the premises na kailangan nating maintindihan with regards to Newtonian mechanics. First one, that is that it is grounded on the use of Newton's three laws of motion. It explains that space or distance, time, and mass are absolute. So, kung babalikan natin ang ating concepts about the three laws of motion, lahat ng ideas na nakapaloob doon ay kasama sa Newtonian mechanics. So, di ba, yung mga three laws of motion, the law of inertia, di ba, yung law of acceleration, and law of interaction, yung tatlong yun ay nakapaloob sa Newtonian mechanics. And we say that space or distance, time, and mass are absolute. Ibig sabihin nito, iisa lang ang way or paraan kung paano natin na-experience ang mga bagay. Halimbawa, kung paano tumatakbo, ang oras ng isang tao ay ganoon din ang pagtakbo ng oras sa lahat ng tao sa mundo. Another example is the way we measure things. Yung 12 inches na ruler, for example, dito sa akin, ay kasing haba rin ang 12 inches na ruler na mayroon kayo dyan sa inyo. Di ba? And kung gaano katagal ang 10 segundo sa akin, ganoon din ito katagal sa inyo. At syempre, kung gaano kabigat ang halimbawa 2 kilo ng asukal, ay ganoon din ito kabigat sa ibang parte ng mundo. Yun yung ibig sabihin na space, time, and mass are absolute. Another premise under the Newtonian mechanics is that the distance between two objects and the time that passes between the two events does not depend on the environment where the object is in. Okay? Next, objects in the environment moves in a straight line. So this is how Newton describes the motion of objects in the environment. Halimbawa, sa laro ng billiard. Kapag tinamaan ng billiard ball, ang isa pang billiard ball, ang motion nito ay in straight line lamang. Diba? Kung ito man ay bumangga sa pool table, ito ay magbabounce off lamang. Pero ang motion nito ay nasa straight line pa rin. Okay? Next, no matter where you are or how fast you are moving, there will be no changes in space or time. Okay, hindi yung parang sasabi niya na space and time are absolute, no? Now, for the electromagnetic theory of light naman, okay, for the other side of the spectrum, it states that the electric field, magnetic field, and light are different representation of the same phenomena or event, no? Just like what I've told earlier about electromagnetic spectrum. Okay, na yung tatlong ito, yung electric field, magnetic field, at saka light, ay related sa isa't isa. And Maxwell further predicted that visible lights are electromagnetic waves that move in a manner like ripples in water when a stone is dropped. So, during our past discussions or live sessions, we already established na yung visible light or yung light can behave both as a particle and as a wave. So Maxwell believed that lights are examples of electromagnetic waves. No, so it moves like ripples of water na kapag may nahulog na bato doon sa ating tubig. No, parang ganun daw yung motion ng light according to Maxwell. Light as a wave have both the electrical and magnetic components and move at a constant speed. It means that the speed of light is the same for everything and for all observers. So that is what Maxwell believed or explained in his electromagnetic theory of light, na yung light daw, ang speed noon ay constant. Kahit saan man or anong mangyari, laging constant ang speed of light. Now, what is the conflict? Ano ba yung nangyari? Ano ba yung nangyari or opposite ideas between these two concepts or theories? So these two ideas, although equally acknowledged by the scientific community, no, syempre yung mga ideas nila importante yon sa scientific community, nagkaroon ng conflict in the things that they are talking about. Okay, so what is the conflict specifically? According to Newton or Newtonian mechanics, all speeds are relative. It depends on the observer's viewpoint and situation. So ibig sabihin, ang speed according to Newton ay relative, nag-iiba-iba, depende doon kung sino yung nag-o-observe or sa situation. So paano yung nangyayari? Halimbawa, no? From a passenger's perspective, the airplane's motion is extremely slow. But in reality, the speed of a plane ranges from 460 to 575 miles per hour. Diba? Sino ba sa inyo dito ang nakasakay na ng eroplano? Diba pag nakasakay ka sa eroplano, parang pag tumingin ka dun sa bintana or dun sa window part, makikita na parang ang bagal ng kilos ng airplane na parang hindi siya masyadong mabilis. Pero from the perspective of someone na nasa baba or nasa ground, yung motion po ng airplane ay napakabilis. Diba? So magkaiba tayo ng way on how we perceive the speed of the plane. Depends on the location or the perspective of the one who is observing. So that is how Newton explained the speed of objects. So sabi niya, varying. Pero according to Maxwell, no, light in a vacuum moves at 186 miles per second and it does not change for all observers and situations. So dito nagkaroon ng conflict yung dalawang theory dahil sa way nila kung paano i-observe ang speed of light. Diba? Kasi according to Newton, the speed of things varies. Depends on how people perceive them. Pero according to Maxwell, hindi. Yung speed ng light ay constant for all observers and any situation. So hindi siya nagbabago. So sino ba yung tama, no? Ano ba yung tama dito? Paano at paano na resolve yung conflict na ito? So dito ngayon papasok yung special theory of relativity. Okay? So in 1905, okay, kilala naman natin kung sino ito, di ba? Albert Einstein published his observation about the differing ideas of these two theories through the special theory of relativity. Okay, now let's talk about the different principles under this theory. So meron siya mga principles, no? The first one is the consistent law principle. So consistent law principle, it talks about that the law of physics are the same in all frames of reference that are moving at a constant velocity with respect to one another. Okay? So ano ba muna yung frame of reference? No, kasi nabanggit dito sa ating definition, yung sa consistent law principle, yung term na frame of reference. So what is frame of reference? Where you are standing is your frame of reference. So yun yung ibig sabihin nun, no? So kung saan ka pala nakatayo or nakaupo as of this moment, ayun yung inyong frame of reference, no? So kung saan ka nakaposition while observing different things, yan ang inyong frame of reference. Halimbawa, ako, currently, nakaupo ako dito sa labas ng hallway ng school, no? Dito ako sa may hallway ng school namin, no? So this means that at this moment, this part of the hallway is my frame of reference. Okay? Another thing, my frame of reference at this moment may be different from my frame of reference after an hour or two. Di ba? It makes sense. Dahil kapag umalis ako dito, kung nasaan ang current location ko, yun ang magiging bagong frame of reference ko. Okay? Another thing with frame of reference is that we can use it to describe motion. Diba, sabi nga natin sa definition ng motion natin, motion is actually relative to a frame of reference. For example, kung ikaw ay nasa loob ng isang tricycle, no, papunta kang school, kung ang frame of reference mo ay ang upuan ng tricycle, you are at rest, no, hindi ka gumagalaw. No, you are not in motion. Pero for the people, no, outside, yung mga nasa sidewalk, you are in motion at yung speed mo, you are moving with the speed the same as the tricycle, no? Yun yung purpose ng frame of reference. Okay. Another one is this example by Einstein. Ito yung ginawa example ni Einstein with regards to how he perceived differences in motion. So for example daw, merong dalawang observer. Yung isang observer dito, yung nakatayong tao, okay? Yung nakatayong tao dito sa sidewalk or sa ground, and then yung isang observer ay nasa loob ng train. And the train is moving at a constant speed. So sabi dito, 4 feet of the speed of the light. Okay. So and then suddenly, nagkaroon ng kidlat, kumidlat, and then simultaneously, sabay na kumidlat doon sa dalawang puno, yung letter A saka yung letter B. Now, the problem is, the way that these two people perceive the event is different, according to Einstein. For letter C, for this person, what he observed is that the lightning struck the two trees at the same time. Kasi nga, sabay niya nakita yung dalawang event. But for the person inside the train, he perceived the event differently. Posibleng nakita niya muna na na-struck ng lightning yung puno na ito, yung letter B, compared to how he observed letter A. Kasi nga, he is also moving together with the train. Okay? So, ito yung sasabi ni Einstein na the way we perceive speed is relative to the observer. So parang nag-agree siya kay ano, no? Ina-agree niya yung statement ni Newton with regards to how we perceive something. So it is dependent to the one who is doing the observation. Okay? Yeah. Another premise or postulate under the special theory of relativity is the constancy of speed. So the speed of light in an empty space has the same magnitude for all observers regardless of their velocity. Okay? Ano naman yung ibig sabihin nito? For example, no, itong picture na ito. Kapag daw meron kang dalawang tao, okay? And then both of them tried to release an arrow from the bow at 200 kilometers per hour. Okay. Now the difference is itong person A na nasa loob ng train ay in motion together with the train. So the train is running at 100 kilometers per hour, and then what will happen is ang gagawin niya, ititira niya yung arrow, release niya yung arrow from the bow with a speed of 200 kilometers per hour. What happened is magbabago po yung speed ng arrow natin kasi kinukonsider niya rin po yung speed ng train. Okay? Unlike itong letter B na stationary, person B, so once he released the arrow from the bow, ang speed lang niya ay magiging 200 kilometers per hour. So magkakaroon sila ng ibang speed because the one that is riding the train, yung person A, medyo nagkaroon siya ng parang tulak, no? Tulong from the train, kaya mas mabilis yung kanyang arrow compared doon sa letter B. Okay, so that is what will happen dito sa situation na ito. Now, unfortunately, for this situation naman, kapag halimbawa daw laser naman yung ni-release, okay, from a device. So laser, alam naman natin, is actually a source of light, no? Kapag laser daw yung inyong ni-release. So again, we have person A and person B. Yung person A is again riding the train, and then yung person B is stationary. Once they release the laser from its source, what will happen is they will arrive at the same time dito sa ating destination. So bakit kaya ganun? Hindi ba dapat mas mauuna yung laser coming from the person A kasi siya ay nakasakay sa train. So merong additional dapat na speed or burst of speed yung light coming from the person na nakasakay sa train. Pero unfortunately, hindi po ganun. Kasi kahit na ganun yung nangyayari, no, meron siyang speed added because of the train's movement, constant pa din po yung speed ng light. Okay? So yun yung sinasabi ni Maxwell na in any given situation, the speed of light remains the same. Hindi siya nagbabago. Okay? And that is actually applied in the special theory of relativity by Einstein. So these two postulates clarify that if two events happen at different places, it is not always likely to say which of the two events happens first or that they occur at the same time. Okay. So in short, although merong conflict, nagkaroon ng conflict yung Newtonian mechanics at saka yung electromagnetic theory of light, itong special theory of relativity was able to marry or let's say, pinagsama niya yung idea ng dalawa to come up with this new theory which is called the special theory of relativity. So he was able to reconcile the two opposing idea. Okay? So yan. So, kumusta naman kaya ang lahat ng ating mga live viewers ngayon? No? Marami ba kayong natutunan sa ating session? Tingnan ko nga yung ating mga comments kung sino-sino ba ang nasa ating comment section for today? Ayan. Okay, so meron dito from San Mariano National High School. So again, thank you for tuning in. No, palagi ko yung nakakasama, palagi every afternoon. And from Padre Garcia National High School. Yeah. Thank you then. And of course, from Buting Senior High School sa mga students. Sa mga students ko na nanonood ngayon, welcome and thank you for the undying support. Okay. So, now let me present to you our learners the activity for today or for this week. Now, the activity is this. You walk towards the back of an airplane that is in space. So ibig sabihin, in transit siya, no? Now you have to describe, how can you determine your speed relative to the ground in your own thinking? So you have to explain your answer by applying the concept of special theory of relativity. Okay? Ayan. So, again, you may submit your output in any of the digital formats sa link na nakikita ninyo sa inyong mga screen. Okay? Enter your name, your grade and section, name of the teacher, your school and SDO, and upload your output to be recognized. The output can be in any format possible. Okay? So just a reminder, your output should be named last name underscore first name para mas madali po naming mahanap kung kaninong files yung aming binabasa. And of course, yung mga best outputs will be considered to be one of the students of the week, next week. Okay, so to summarize everything that we've learned for today, the first one is Hertz produced radio waves using his spark gap transmitter. And the special relativity theory resolved the conflict between the Newtonian mechanics and electromagnetic theory of light. Okay, now let's move on to our quiz segment na pinangalanan po natin Gets Mo, Sagot Mo. Sa segment na ito, ay may sasagutan po tayong 5 questions. Now, of course, taken from what we had shared to you earlier. We are inviting everyone to have fun and sumali sa ating Gets Mo, Sagot Mo segment. Just comment your answers in the comment section. Alright, so let's get started. Number 1. The result of Heinrich Hertz's experiment confirmed which of the following scientific theory? Letter A, Newtonian mechanics. B, quantum information theory. C, Einstein's theory of relativity. Or letter D, Maxwell's electromagnetic theory. Okay? The answer is letter D, Maxwell's electromagnetic theory. Number 2, in what part of the transmitter did Hertz see electrical spark? A, switch. B, battery. C, spark gap. Or letter D, conductor. The answer is letter C, spark gap. Number 3. It is based on the application of Newton's 3 laws of motion, which assumes that the concepts of distance and time are absolute. A, special relativity. B, electromagnetism. C, Newtonian mechanics. Or letter D, Newton's law of universal gravitation. The answer is letter C, Newtonian mechanics. Number 4. Which of the following devices does not use radio waves? A, radar. B, mobile phones. C, television remote control. Or letter D, handheld transceiver or walkie-talkie. Okay, the answer is letter C, television remote control, because it uses infrared. Okay? And number 5, which of the following is a postulate of special relativity? A, the color of light is the same for all observers. B, the relative speed of two objects is the same for all observers. C, physicists can make no measurement in a moving reference frame. Or letter D, the laws of physics are the same for all observers in uniformly moving frames of reference. The answer is letter D. So, ang topic po natin na tinalakay ngayong hapon ay nakabatay sa content ng Physical Science ADM Modules 12-13 ng Region 4A Calabar Zone. Salamat po sa inyong pagsama sa amin sa aking nakaraang 40 minutes na umati kabung live session patungkol sa radio waves at special theory of relativity.